So we identified a need for this clinic because we found that there were so many patients that they had recovered from the initial, you know, COVID infection, but they were having these long-term problems. And the problems, you know, vary really widely, but we realized there was a big need for this post-COVID care. As far as the symptoms that we see, I mean, it really varies. I would say the most common ones we see are fatigue and shortness of breath. We see a lot of headaches though too, paresthesias or numbness and tingling as well, palpitations, chest pain, muscle aches and pains. It really does vary a lot. Some people even with some different vision changes or dizziness. We have patients list their top five symptoms that are most bothersome to them, and that kind of helps direct the care. And then the patients will also see pharmacy as well as physical therapy. And then we have a neuropsychologist, Dr. Zicardi, that sees patients as needed as well too. We are finding that a lot of patients are having, you know, yeah, psychological problems, or, you know, say they had some anxiety and depression before, maybe it's now worse. So a referral to the long hauler clinic needs to come from another Parkview provider. It feels great to be able to help them and to provide that reassurance that, you know, you're not alone. A lot of people are having these problems, because a lot of patients come in thinking like, oh no, I'm crazy. Like, no one could still be having these problems, you know, a year later. But there are a lot of people, you know, and we do have a support group, you know, for these patients that meets once a month to try to help, you know, provide that reassurance and, you know, additional education and things that we found. And I'm very upfront with my patients that we're still learning a lot about COVID too and post-COVID, so we try to share the information we have.
I was seeing a lot of post-COVID patients with long-haul symptoms, meaning symptoms that were greater than 30 days. They have a complexity of symptoms, right, that are persisting, and they're so frustrated because they're going from specialty to specialty to specialty. And so the parents are missing work, the child is missing school, they're not getting a set diagnosis. And we started the clinic on December 2nd, and it's been going very well. And we've had a lot of really good patient feedback. So the whole goal of the clinic is to provide multidisciplinary care in one clinic visit so that they don't have to be referred out necessarily to lots of other pediatric subspecialties. A significant amount of these patients are also having anxiety and depression over feeling just kind of defeated by the whole diagnosis and the fact that they're not feeling better, and it's been, you know, at least 30 days, if not months and months and months. And so we do an anxiety and depression screen, and then we have an honest conversation about how this is typical with the COVID long haulers, and that it's relative to, you know, maybe not being as involved in school or not being involved with your activities that you previously were. But there's also a physiological reason too, is that with COVID, we're seeing that there's a lot of neuro excitement or overstimulation, and that will really cause a lot of anxiety and depression too. And so we want them to understand that, you know, it's not just them. And so we provide them a lot of reassurance in the office that, you know, you can't do this by yourself. You need guidance, and that's exactly what we're here to do. And I think sometimes just giving them hope is exactly what they need. Once you're out of your quarantine, you can't just go back to school full time, right? If you're still having persisting symptoms, then you need to take this incrementally. And you can't go back to playing and training for soccer every day. You have to do that incrementally as well. And then we've also just asked the schools to give these kids grace and let them know that these symptoms really do exist. And if we push them too hard, the science shows that they'll step back, they won't step forward, and their symptoms will persist even longer. Fundamentally, right now, our systems are good. I think we're tailoring correctly of the clinic to what the families need. I want this clinic in the future to be known and to know that it's available and for it to be easily accessible. And we did kind of mimic what the adult clinic was doing because we wanted to have consistent care, right? And so you have to be 18 years or younger. You have to have had positive COVID testing or positive COVID antibodies, and you had to have had symptoms for longer than 30 days. If they meet that criteria, then we would take a referral from their primary care.